Please
grab the glass. Madam, please present the flower pot. Present the flower pot.
It is autonomous PRPs. The remaining plasma has 5 to 10. An important thing is how we just take around 80 ml of blood of the patient itself, and then we put it in 2 conical tubes, 9 ml, 9 ml. Then we put 1 ml of EDTA in both the tubes, and then we centrifuge it for around 15 minutes at the speed of 3000 to 4000 RPM. Then the upper layer and the buffy layer is taken in another tube. The lower one is full of RBCs, it is left. Then it is again centrifuged for around 15. Whenever you do a surgery of such uterus, the uterus itself becomes very weak. So it might lead to complications at the time of delivery and cesarean. I did a hysteroscopy. I injected PRP in the endometrium. And she had beautiful endometrium. She conceived it right now. She is around 4 to 5 months pregnant. The lower patient from Agra, she was also very bad uterus. Then in fact, in first cervix was very small, uterus was very small. In first cycle, we just lost the embryos because we were trying to reject, but there was nothing that I wasn't able to do that. But in the second cycle, the rest embryos give growth, and then I did a hysteroscopy because she was a patient from Agra. So you know, they don't come often. So I did see the ribosome, whatever she has got, when she was sending me, and I just took her on the table on the day of transfer. On the day of pickup, I didn't even thought of looking at the endometrium or things like that, because pickup is, you know, very fast, and there are a number of patients kept. Variety of substances still completely known, although lab studies show that high concentration of growth factors in PRP can speed up the healing process. Growth factors promote bone healing by initiating the following stages: tissue necrosis, resolution, hemostasis, cell regeneration, cell proliferation and migration, extracellular matrix synthesis, remodeling, angiogenesis and epithelialization. And initially we used to use recombinant human growth factor. But now PRP is proved superior to this, as magnet activation leads to release of multiple growth factors and differentiation factors. It actually acts like stem cells. So we already know that stem cells can create everything, and it also acts like that. And taking stem cells is a very tedious process. You have to go through bone marrow and all those things. So this PRP is very simpler and very cheap also. Now the use of PRP in cervical ectopy. Hua et al. Conducted RCT to compare effectiveness of autologous PRP application through laser treatment for benign cervical ectopy erosion with 1 week interval in face treated by topical and systemic corticosteroids. Application of PRP in cases of LS resistant to steroid therapy in 28 patients with LS by injecting PRP into vulva and phallic pattern. Patients received 3 PRP treatments 4 to 6 weeks apart and again in 12 months. Nearly all patients exhibited clinical improvement in lesion size, and in 28.6% of patients, lesions disappeared completely after PRP treatment. Minimal pain and no complication was reported. So PRP injection should be considered effective therapy for LS. I have used for this. I had a patient, she had vulvar dystrophy. I sent her to specialist, and he was like, he took a biopsy, he gave some treatment, and after some time, usne bhi haath khade kar diye ki ma'am kuch liye just counsel her. Then I said, why not give it a trial? And I gave it a trial of PRP, and she responded. PRP in reconstructive surgery for vulval cancer. Moray et al. Conducted retrospective study of patients who underwent surgery for vulval cancer, radial vulvectomy. Aim was to evaluate efficacy of platelet gel application in women with radical surgery. Divided patients into two groups. Group A had patients gel based on vaginal treatment. After PRP application, endometrial thickness was satisfactory in 7 cases. molecules which could be improved by KRT activation. This has been trying a lot, but we are doing microscopically. We inject the endometrium, just below the endometrium we inject KRT at 4 to 6 places in the uterus, and in the next month, in the previous cycle of the patient, like we have to do her IVF in June, then we will inject in May. And they have beautiful endometrium, good blood supply, and they really become pregnant and carry the baby till term also. Now the active refractory endometrium, Zelenogorals et al. Included 10 patients who had history of cancerous cycles due to inadequate endometrial growth less than 7 mm. Endometrial thickness increased at the activation and reached more than 7 mm after second PRP activation in all patients. Embryo transfer was carried out in all patients. 5 patients remained pregnant and in 4 of them pregnancy processed normally. Conclusion, PRP was effective for endometrial growth in patients with thin endometrium. This even I have done so many patients whom I just couldn't get endometrial in spite of doing anything. First of all, I did hysteroscopic PRP.
Anyway, it is suppressed. So this won't be very effective.
Very effective.
fight this different battle. And second, I think there was another question for somebody else. That also happened in this case, if you know the path, how it works. Because even in here, it was yeah, that this works basically by reducing